We're going to go over what to expect when you're working with a realtor to purchase your first home. Let's do this. How's it going? My name is John and I am a mortgage broker located in Vancouver, and welcome to another video. If this is your first time here and you want to learn ways to approve for a mortgage, home buying tips and other mortgage related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking on the notification bell so you won't miss anything. I am here today with Dennis Holt, realtor with Sutton West Coast Realty, and we're going to talk about the home buying process. How's it going, Dennis?
I'm good, John. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, we're excited to have you here because I have lots of clients looking to purchase their first home. And of course, they need to find a realtor, but they don't really know what to expect. So what should they expect when they're seeing a realtor like yourself?
So for anyone buying their first home, the process can be quite overwhelming. I've broken the process down into 5 steps to simplify the process.
And what would be the first step be?
First would be called a consultation phase. The consultation phase will talk about the type of homes that you want to look at, the potential areas, timelines, and expectations, and any common concerns you may have.
And for this phase, would the pre-approval for mortgage be also be discussed as well?
Yes, the pre-approval phase is very important because getting pre-approved, you can set an expectation on your budget, and therefore it can be very competitive in the market today.
So now that you figure out kind of what the client wants, what would be the next step then?
The next step will be viewings. Over the next couple of weeks, you'll be receiving emails with potential listings that matches our criteria. And if there's anything that you like, we can set up a viewing and see it in person with COVID protocols in mind.
Just in general, and on average, like how long would this process take?
The process can take about 2 to 3 months, or it could be even quicker. It really depends on how much inventory is in the market today and how competitive the market is.
And if your clients found something that they really like and they want to put an offer in, what would be the discussion be and what would that look like?
You're bang on. The third part will be the offer phase. And before any offers, I will be conducting a detailed market analysis for you. And from there, we'll review the contract of purchase and sale. We'll talk about the price. We'll talk about the deposit. We'll look at items are included, subjects and terms.
In general, how long would this subject period be?
Typically, a subject period would range from 5 to 7 business days. But with COVID right now, some can be as long as 14 business days.
Wow, okay. And I guess once we get closer to the subject removal date, what would the client need to do if they plan on removing the subject?
So that would be the fourth phase of this, writing an offer. During the subject phase, we'll be doing our due diligence to make sure that, for one, we can get the mortgage. Two, we want to do a home inspection. Three, we want to review any documents that there may be, such as minutes, insurance, and also title and property disclosure statements.
After the reviewing all of that, and if everything's okay, then what's the next step?
The next step will be removing the subjects. And once you remove the subjects, you have to pay your deposit. And once the deposit is paid, the deal is firm.
And then, yeah, I guess you just wait until the completion date?
And that'll be the final step, completion. So at the completion phase, you'll meet with your mortgage broker to finalize your mortgage. You'll also want to buy home insurance. And lastly, meet with your lawyers to complete the deal.
So that seems really easy. And then after removing subject and then it just completes, but I have a feeling it's not that easy. There are other things that someone would need to make sure they have funds for. Are there any hidden costs or taxes that buyers should be aware of?
Yeah, surprisingly, a lot of buyers think that homes are tax-free. There's always tax on properties unless there's a specific exemption. So one of the first taxes I want to touch on is a property transfer tax. The property transfer tax is 1% on the first $200,000 and 2% on the balance. So for example, on a $300,000 property, you have to pay $4,000 in property transfer tax.
And from my understanding from the mortgage side, you actually can't borrow that tax. Someone, you need to actually have the cash in order to pay that property transfer tax.
Yeah. And also another tax I want to touch on is the GST. For any brand new properties that you purchase, there'll be a 5% GST that is added onto the cost. So for example, going back to $300,000, you'll have to pay a $15,000 GST tax.
And that's only on brand new?
And that's only on brand new properties.
Properties. Are there any exemptions for both of these?
Yeah, there are. So if you're a first-time home buyer, you can save the property transfer tax. So if you buy any used home under $500,000, you can save the property transfer tax.
For brand new properties, up to $750,000?
Yes. So,
I guess.
So for brand new properties, if you want to buy a pre-sale, you can save the property transfer tax up to $750,000, and you do not have to be a first-time home buyer as well. But you have to live in the property, so it has to be your principal residence.
So then, as for those who are watching right now and they're first-time home buyers, what other tips will you give to them?
So one of the biggest tips I can give is finding someone that you want to work with. Because buying a home can be quite a complex experience. So if you can find someone that you work with, it will make the experience much more fun and much more worthwhile. And also, finding a really good mortgage broker will help with that too.
Thank you so much for joining us, Dennis. That's really great tips.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
And there you go. We just shared with you what to expect when you're working with a realtor to purchase your first home. And please remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel to learn more. And make sure you click on the notification bell so you won't miss a video. I'm John Lee, mortgage broker and CEO of Rise Mortgage. We're always achieving your approval.